a numerical problem on gas turbine system. Please understand if you understand this problem, numerical problem, then every problem you can solve easily on gas turbine. Now we will explain the figure. First you draw the figure. Low pressure compressor 1 to 2. Then intercooler 2 to 3. Then high pressure compressor 2, 3 to 4. Then 4 to 5 heat exchanger. Then 5 to 6 is the gas boiler or burner, gas chamber, combustion chamber. Fuel is added here. 6 to 7 is high pressure turbine 1. Now this compressor turbine, this is coupled with the shaft. Then from 6 to 7 is high pressure turbine. Okay, 7 to 8, again here is a gas boiler. Okay, then 8 to 9 is a low pressure turbine 2, is an alternator, and from 9 it again goes to heat exchanger, then to air. Now I think you have drawn the figure. Okay, now the problem data are given. Please note down the video is to be seen first. To note down all the data and figure and read it and write down, then you read, then you see the video again. Now total head isentropic efficiency of each compressor is equal to 80%. Okay, total head pressure ratio of each compressor is equal to 2:1. Total head pressure loss in intercooler is equal to 0.06 kg per centimeter square. Now here you can convert it to newton per millimeter square or newton per meter square, as you like. Total head pressure loss on each side of heat exchanger is equal to 0.1 kg per centimeter square. This is kg per centimeter square. Thermal ratio of heat exchanger is equal to 75%. Total head pressure loss in combustion chamber is equal to 0.12 kg per centimeter square. combustion efficiency of main burner B1 gas burner is equal to 98%. Fuel burner, of course, total head isentropic efficiency of compressor turbine, combined 87%. Mechanical transmission efficiency for compressor turbine set, is equal to 99%. Total head pressure loss in reheater, here it is heat exchanger, okay, is equal to 0.1 kg per centimeter square. Combustion efficiency of reheater B2, okay, that is equal to 98%. Total head isentropic efficiency of power turbine, is equal to 80%. Ambient pressure is equal to 1.032 kg per centimeter square. Ambient temperature is equal to 15 degree centigrade is equal to 288 Kelvin, not degree Kelvin, this is only Kelvin. Okay, 288 Kelvin, okay. Now, ambient temperature we have told you, 288 Kelvin. Maximum cycle temperature is equal to 1000 Kelvin, okay, I think. And then air mass flow rate 23 kg per second, Cp of air is equal to 0.24, it is in kilocalorie per Kelvin, gamma is equal to 1.4 during compression, and Cp of gas is equal to 0.276 and gamma is equal to for gas 1.333 during heating and expansion. Calorific value of fuel is equal to 10300 kilocalorie per kg. Calculate 1. The net power output, 2. The specific fuel consumption, number 3. The overall thermal efficiency. Now please write down the step. Step 1, you go on writing first and then you see the video again. Step 1, P12 is equal to is the total pressure head at 1 is equal to actually P1. Here there is no dynamic temperature. So this is equal to 1.032 kg per centimeter square. Okay, so P1T is equal to T1. Now here this is the total head temperature is equal to T1. Here also the velocity is 0, so this is also a dynamic temperature is 0, so it is also a static temperature T1, 288 Kelvin. Thus point 1 is defined completely. Okay, then come the step 2. Here to solve this problem you must see my previous videos, because the notations are used here with respect to the previous one. T2T minus T1T is equal to T2T dash minus T1T by efficiency of the compressor. Okay, this is equation which I have given in the earlier video. You will see the isentropic efficiency of the compressor here, this one, you see it now, is equal to, you take common this one, so RC1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1 by NC. Okay, now I will roll on, because you see there is no point of explaining again. Okay, now this is the data already been given. RC1 2 is to 1 will be na gamma T1 T NC. So what can you find out from this equation? We can find out T2 is known. So what will be the T2? T2 will be equal to, just you do the substitution. Okay, that will be, this will be the T2 in Kelvin. Okay, now P2T is equal to RC1 into P1T. So 2 RC1 is given 2, RC1 is equal to RC2 is equal to 2, this is given. Okay, thus point 2 is defined. Okay, now P3 point, then come to step 3. This one actually step 2, I have told you. Now P3T is equal to P2T minus delta PIC intercooler. Delta P is given 0.06 is equal to 2 kg per centimeter. Delta P is equal to, it is given IC in the question. So this is known. What is known? P3T. Now let us find out T3T. We are all points we are going to define with pressure and temperature. Now this is T3T is equal to T1T. Why? Because we want to intercool to initial temperature, that is here atmospheric temperature. temperature. Okay, that's why this is equal. T3T is equal to T1T, and in turn T1T is given. Okay, T3T is equal to T1T is equal to this one, not degree, you omit the degree. So it is okay. Okay. Thus point 3 is defined. Similarly, I will roll on very fast. The same way all points can be found out. Okay, this is the same way, these formulas are very similar. The compressor 2, RCTO is also 2, so you just put the value, okay, that will be this one, not degree, huh? So this is okay. 366.8436 Kelvin. This is what? This is the T4T. Thus, point 4 is defined, means P and T are found out. 5. Same pressure drop in heat exchanger from air side. There are two sides. One is air side, another is gas side. But T5T is not possible to find now. Nothing is given. Na? Thus, till point 5 is undefined. We will do it in a subsequent steps. P6 point. Let us step 6. Same. The delta P is a combustion chamber. It is given. Point 12 is given. Pressure loss. Okay. So T60 is equal to. Now it is to be understood that T60 is the T60 and T80. This will be the maximum temperature, T60 and T80. This is the maximum temperature of the attained. It is 1000 Kelvin given in the problem. Thus, point 6 is defined. Okay. Step 7. Now, work required by the compressors, that there are two compressors, WC, is given by WC is equal to, this is very simple, this is the fat compressor CPC into T22, this is the first and this is the second compressor. Okay, so total is added. This is actually negative work on the system. Okay, okay. Now this will be 37.845 K kilocalorie per kg. Okay. Now here the work output in the coupled system. Work output of compressor turbine. Okay, this is in the set, compressor turbine set. This is the work of the compressor divided by the mechanical efficiency between compressor and turbine. This is given 0.99%. So this will be slightly more in the turbine. Now again, work output of the compressor turbine side is this gas side. So this is the formula. Okay, and these two you can equate. This one is equating with the this one. Okay, so this, from this equation, we can find out what T70. So this is this one at much Kelvin, not degree. Okay, this much Kelvin. Now the efficiency of the turbine, this is already been defined when we have done in the turbine. Okay, so 1/RT1 into gamma minus 1 by gamma, because you see this is actually T60 by T7-T, this is equal to RT. This by this is equal to RT. So this by this will be 1/RT1 into gamma minus 1 by gamma. Now RT1 is given. So this is given 87% efficiency of the turbine. So this we are substituting to find out RT1. So RT1 can be found out directly. This one. Now P70 is equal to P60 by P70 is equal to P60 by RT1. This is the formula, you know. So this is this, like this. Okay. Kg per centimeter square. What? P70. Thus, 0.7 is defined. Now you see step 8. P80, I will roll on. Delta P in the heat exchanger, the heat burner B2. Sorry, this is for delta P for reheat burner B2. So this is given. This is delta P is given. Okay, kg per centimeter square. So T80. Is equal to T60 minus is equal to 1000 Kelvin. This I have told you earlier. This is the maximum temperature of the plant. Thus, 0.8 is defined completely. It will be continuing in the next video. Okay.